welcome to Marcon Chaka. It's a thrill to have an audience tonight, and we're so pleased that you have come here to enjoy this evening with us. When I started planning this concert with Nicholas McGegan months and months ago, I thought I wanted to do something to make it special, even if we didn't have an audience. And so I think you'll see what some of those special things are. I wanted the students to have a good time tonight. And so now I think we can all have a good time. The restrictions have been loosened, and we're able to do more than we've been able to do in 2 years. And we're thrilled to have you here. I just wanted to invite Nick McGegan to say a few words about the program before we get started.
Thanks. I'm the talking program note. The program has a general title of Regency Delights, but it's a little wider than that. The Regency in England is technically from about 1811 to 1820. But what we're presenting here is music that would have been enjoyed by people during those years, which means some of it was written quite a long time before that. It took a little while to get popular. And so what we have are a number of different strands. One is one that I find particularly fascinating, and that is that at least half a dozen songs in this program were copied out by Jane Austen. In her private music books, she would get up early because some of her brothers and sisters didn't like music as much, so she would practice before they were awake. But she wrote out the songs she liked, and so particularly the songs of Dibdin that you will hear and Queen Mary's Lament come from her songbooks and are mostly in her handwriting. We then have, as it were, Broadway tunes from the period, also Dibdin show tunes, if you like, that were popular. We also have music, interestingly, by a man called Ignatius Sancho, who was born actually on a boat on the way to becoming a slave in America, but he got whisked back when he was 2 and grew up in London working for the Duke of Montague, and he was the first person of African descent to vote in the United Kingdom. He ran a shop, wrote music, and his letters, his abolitionist letters, are very famous. So we have a couple of his songs in this program. The third strand, if you like, is the Scottish-Irish bit. By the 1790s, it had become very trendy to like Scotland. One of the reasons was that gentlemen could no longer go on the grand tour to Italy because Napoleon stopped that. So they said, well, let's take our holidays at home. And so they went to Wales and to Scotland, and they cavorted around Lake District, of course, and Wordsworth. So the publisher, George Thompson, invited composers of the day, and we'll see two of them tonight, Haydn and Beethoven, to set Scottish and Irish folk songs for domestic use with that new and ubiquitous instrument of this period, the fortepiano, or the pianoforte. I'm playing one which is a copy of one from exactly that period. And of course, this means that for the Scottish pieces, Robert Burns and Sir Walter Scott are providing some of the texts, together with the son of James Boswell, the biographer of Samuel Johnson. So this is, as it were, a canapé plate of music from these various strands.
So just two final things. In the program, I think we got a little overzealous and we figured we really were going to hear the encore, so it was printed. The final song, Charlie is My Darling, is an encore. So if you really, really want to hear it, clap a lot after Auld Lang Syne. And then also, because in rehearsing the program, we realized that the set that's called Loss...
Love and Loss.
Love and Loss. We needed to change the order a bit. So we're doing all of the songs, but we switched the order around, and I think it'll be pretty clear as to which one you'll be hearing.
Thank you so much. It's a test.
A test, exactly. Thank you so much. Enjoy the concert.
Clap when you like.
Let bucks and let bloods to praise London agree, or the choice of the country mine true for me, where sweet is the flower of the May bush adorns, and how charming to gather it back for the font, where we walk o'er the mountains with health our cheeks glow, as warm as the toast honey, well it and snowy, where nature to smile when she joyful inclines, and the sun charms us all the year round when it shines. Oh, the mountains and valleys and bushes, the pigs and the screech owls and thrushes, let bucks and let bloods to praise London agree, oh, the joys of the country, my June, for me. The joys of the country, my jewel for me. There 12 hours on a stretch we in angling delight, as patient as Job, though we ne'er get a bite. There we paw at the wild ducks and frighten the crows, once so lovely the icicles hang from our clothes. There with aunts and with cousins and grandmothers talking, we are caught in the rain as we're all out of walking, while the muslins and gauzes cling round each fair she, that they look all like Venuses sprung from the sea. Oh, the mountains and valleys and bushes, the pigs and the screech owls and thrushes, let bucks and let bloods to praise London agree, oh, the joys of the country, my jewel, for me, the joys of the country, my jewel, for me. Then how sweet in the dog days to take the fresh air, where to save you expense the dust powders your hair. Their pleasures like snowballs increase as they roll, and tire you to death, not forgetting the ball, where in mirth and good fellowship always delighting we agree, that is when we're not squabbling and fighting, then with toasts and pint bumpers we order the head, just to see you most gracefully stagger to bed. Oh, the mountains and valleys and bushes, the pigs and the screech owls and thrushes, let bucks and let bloods to praise London agree. Oh, the joys of the country, my jewel, for me. The joys of the country, my jewel, for me.
Jolly Dick, the lamplighter, they say the sun's me dad. And truly I believe it, sir, for I'm a pretty lad. The father and I, the world do lie and make it look so gay. The difference is I light by night and father light by day. The difference is I light by night and father light by day. And father light by day. But father's not the likes of I for knowing life and fun. For I queer tricks and fancies spy, folks never show the sun. Rogues, owls and bats can't bear the lie, I've heard your wise one say. And so do your mind, I seize at night, things never see my day. things never seen by day, things never seen by day. At night and lay aside all as quite a useless task, and many a face and many a heart will then pull off the mask. Each formal prude and holy white I grow disguise away, and see it openly all night, who say it in all day, and see it openly all night, who say it in all day, who say it in all day. Boy, I think you can clap for that one.
Some tear, always the sun, the blossom tear. Thank you. Let us have one bottle more. When one
lights are keening glasses on court, and the lasses on court will toss the welcome greeting of hearts in union meeting, and oh, for our next merry meeting, the father's
heart comes here, fill my good fellow, fill my my good fellow, and let's be merry and mellow, and let us have one bottle.
Yeah. and Scotty sheep him round their bricks to chain him. The shaggy was their darling, the young chevalier. Oh, Charlie,